And the bass keeps running, running, and 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 in this context. Hello there, PWR members. I'm George Dyer with this week's Power Minute. Today I'd like to welcome three of our PWR board members, Phil Jones, Christine McGowan, and Ray Fernandez. Thank you for joining us today. We really appreciate it. It's election time again here at PWR. And if you think that you have what it takes to become a director here at the association, we definitely encourage you to visit pwr.net and apply before the April 24th deadline. Being a director is a great opportunity to give back to the realtor community, make new contacts, and really just expand your network within the realtor community. So I'm going to ask a few questions, and each one of the board members are kind of give us their perspective. What made each of you decide to run for the board? So I guess what I'm asking is what motivated you? How did you get into it initially, Phil?
Well, many years ago, I was asked to become involved in organized real estate, served on a couple of committees, and then was asked to run for the board of directors. And have always had an interest in the organized side of real estate, the benefits that our members receive from it, and advancing those as much as possible.
Okay. All right. Great. Christine, how about yourself?
I had been involved on our grievance committee as well as pro standards, and I was asked to run for board of directors and wanted to get more involved on that level.
Okay. All right. Great. Ray?
I'm still very new to the industry. 3 years. This month, 3 years. And I went to a YPN event, and that was a lot of fun, a Young Professional Network event. And a couple weeks later, I got the email about the PWR Board of Directors election, and I thought that seemed like it would be something beneficial, and I wanted to help the association however I could, so I applied and got involved.
Okay, great. Sounds like you're all very enthusiastic about it, which is great. I know you're all busy people. Phil, you have a very successful brokerage in Long Beach. Christine, you're involved with WCR, and you teach our new Power Start program here at PWR. Ray, you're on the Tech Task Force, and you co-chair YPN. So how do you all make the time to do this, and how does it affect your real estate, your day job?
Phil? You know, I actually think we benefit from our involvement. We gain information that we may not get until later on, so we have access to information early on. But in terms of the time, there really isn't. It's not as great a time commitment as I think people believe that it is. We don't meet monthly. We meet every other month. So,
okay,
and we do a lot of it electronically.
Oh, right, of course. Christine, how about you? How do you manage your real estate life and your board responsibilities?
I'm going to echo Phil and say that we do meet every other month, and there's a lot of communication that takes place electronically as well. So it's not as cumbersome as one might think.
Okay, all right. And Ray, how's it been for you?
No, I agree. It's every other month, so it's not too bad, and it's not near much of a time commitment as one might think.
Okay, all right, great. So what kind of person should apply to be a director on the PWR board? I guess what I'm asking is what kind of person does it take to be successful, would you say? Phil,
well, I think they probably should be an Aries. Actually, I just somebody that's enthusiastic and genuinely vested in our business and making sure we continue to improve our industry.
Okay, all right. Christine, what are your thoughts on that?
Someone who wants to get involved should have a genuine care about our industry and care about what services and quality we provide to the membership.
Okay, all right. Barry?
Along with everything they said, I think the personality type. As realtors, we all kind of have a similar personality, and we're looking for somebody that's personable and outgoing, somebody that wants to be involved and share their knowledge with other realtors.
Okay. And it's important that they're very active in the industry. Yeah. We're looking for people that have a great deal of success and familiarity with the trials and tribulations that all of us face in the business.
Okay. All right.
And it's a great group of people.
Great group, yeah, that's for sure. Christine, if elected, what will that director's year typically look like? So just kind of like your overview, what is your year like?
Well, as a new director this previous year, we started out with a strategic planning retreat. which was, we go away and we plan a year out what our objectives and goals are. And there's a lot of fun as well, some team building activities, and then we meet every other month.
How has being a director benefited you as an HRA?
So for me, it's been networking. I believe I've met a lot of new agents at association events and committees and people I would have never known before. And in a way, it's helped me get offers accepted when I'm competing against five or six other offers, and they have met them at the association. They know I'm a guy that is involved and hopefully knows what I'm doing.
Okay, great. That's a good benefit. Phil, any last words of encouragement for anyone that's interested in applying to be on the board?
Well, I think it's important for everybody to know that this isn't a closed club. In fact, we are very intentional in changing the board makeup. We want it to evolve to match the demographics. More young individuals like Christine and Ray, they are both first year directors, and I think they bring so much to it. So we're looking for people that have not done this board to be more involved and get involved and at least submit an application.
Right, I understand. Got it. I'd like to thank our guests today. I'd like to thank Phil and Christine and Ray for sharing their thoughts on being board members. And this will wrap it up for this week's Power Minute. Thank you for tuning in. And running, 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 and running.